Hello friends, welcome to GVK Academy channel. Today we are going to discuss previous year's question in fluid mechanics, fluid properties part 3. So let's start the video. So first question, compressibility force in fluid motion is due to elastic property of fluid. So here given the compressibility of force, so let us discuss different types of forces which are acting on the fluid. So different types of force acting on the flowing fluid are gravitational force, that is self-weight, and pressure force, viscous force, turbulent force, compressive force, and surface tension force. During the derivation of the equation, Newton's equation consider gravitational, pressure, viscous, turbulent force, compressive force, and surface tension. All the forces he considered. Coming to Reynolds equation, gravitational force, pressure force, viscous force, and turbulent. Coming to Navier-Stokes equation, gravitational force, pressure force, and viscous force. And we know that during the derivation of Euler's equation of motion, we will consider gravitational and pressure force. Please remember all these things. Next question. The surface tension of mercury at normal temperature compared to that of water is more. Yes, mercury surface tension will be more than the water because mercury has more cohesive than water. So note point is surface tension is due to cohesion. Therefore, more cohesion of fluid means more surface tension. Next question. The density of water is maximum at which temperature he asking. Therefore, option C, 4 degrees centigrade. So note point is water has its maximum density of 1 gram per centimeter cube or 1000 kg per meter cube at 4 degrees centigrade when temperature greater or less than 4 degrees centigrade, the density will be less than 1000 kg per meter cube. So remember this point. Okay. Next question. Match list 1 and list 2 and select the correct answer using the code below. Yes. List 1 is compressibility, gravity, viscosity, and vapor pressure. List 2 is resistance against shear deformation, cavitation, hydraulic jump, and freight of supersonic aircraft. So answer is option B, 4312. That is compressibility is matched with fourth option, flight of supersonic aircraft, and gravity is matching with hydraulic jump, and viscosity is resistance against shear deformation. So as it is, definition is given in the option. Next, vapor pressure is due to vapor pressure matches with cavitation. So let us understand compressibility points. So compressibility is inversely proportional to bulk modulus, right? Next point is in compressibility is if Mach number less than 0.3, then the flow is called incompressible flow. If Mach number greater than 0.3, the flow is called compressible flow. If Mach number 1 to 3, then it is supersonic. Coming to cavitation, what is cavitation? When it will occur, when at any section in a pipe, if pressure becomes less than the vapor pressure of the flowing fluid, then cavitation will be occur. So if you want to know depth about cavitation and vapor pressure, I have already made the video on vapor pressure and cavitation. Please watch that video. You can get in-depth knowledge about vapor pressure and cavitation. Next question. When a pressure of 2 into 10 to the power of 4 kilonewton per meter square is applied to 50 liter of a liquid, its volume is decreased by 0.5 liter. Then the bulk modulus of liquid in newton per meter square. So what is given? प्रेशर गिवन इज इक्वल टू 2 × 10⁴ किलो न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. देन वॉल्यूम इज गिवन एज 20 लीटर्स, दैट इज 50 × 10⁻³ मीटर क्यूब. देन वॉल्यूम डिक्रीज्ड बाई 0.5 लीटर. सो आस्किंग बल्क मॉडल्स, वी हैव फॉर्मूला के इज इक्वल टू प्रेशर बाई चेंज इन वॉल्यूम बाई ओरिजिनल वॉल्यूम. इफ यू कीप दिस वैल्यूज एंड इफ यू सॉल्व, यू विल गेट इट एज 2 × 10⁹ न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर. सो ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इफ ए सॉलिड स्टील स्पीयर ऑफ 10,000 सेंटीमीटर क्यूब इज सब्जेक्टेड टू ए यूनिफॉर्म हाइड्रोस्टैटिक प्रेशर ऑफ 700 इंटू 10⁴ kg पर मीटर स्क्वायर, देन डिक्रीज इन वॉल्यूम ऑफ द स्पीयर फॉर 1/k इज इक्वल टू, दैट इज कंप्रेसिबिलिटी इज इक्वल टू 6 × 10⁻¹ के जी पर मीटर स्क्वायर. सो मीटर स्क्वायर इनवर्स, राइट? ओके. सो वॉट इज गिवेन, गिवेन डाटा इज वॉल्यूम गिवेन 10,000 सेंटीमीटर क्यूब, राइट, एंड प्रेशर गिवेन 700 × 10⁴ के जी ऑफ पर मीटर स्क्वायर. देन 1/k, दैट इज कंप्रेसिबिलिटी गिवेन एज 6 × 10⁻¹. देन वॉट ई आस्किंग, चेंज इन वॉल्यूम ई इज आस्किंग. वी नो दैट द फॉर्मूला के इज इक्वल टू प्रेशर बाई चेंज इन वॉल्यूम बाई ओरिजिन वॉल्यूम. फ्रॉम दिस वी कैन कैलकुलेट चेंज इन वॉल्यूम एंड बी वी मेक श्योर दैट यू शुड नॉट मेक मिस्टेक इन द यूनिट कन्वर्जन. सो केयरफुल हियर. एंड इफ यू सॉल्व वी विल गेट इट एज 4.2 सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. सो ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द हॉरिजेंटल प्लेट्स आर प्लेस्ड 14 mm अपार्ट एंड द स्पेस बिटवीन देम इज फिल्ड विथ एन ऑयल ऑफ विस्कोसिटी 14 पॉइस. इफ द अपर प्लेट इज मूव विथ 2.5 मीटर पर सेकेंड वेलोसिटी, द शियर स्ट्रेस इन द ऑयल इज. सो गिवन डाटा इज, सो देर इज ए प्लेट, टू प्लेट्स, दे आर सेपरेटेड बाई 14 mm distance, that is y, and given viscosity 14 points. If you convert in MKS unit 1.4 Pascal second and velocity given 2.5 meter per second, then asking shear stress. We know that the formula this, if you keep all the values you will get it as 250 Newton per meter square. So option D is the correct answer. So next question, the pressure difference between inside and outside of a soap bubble of diameter D in terms of surface tension is. So he given is soap bubble, then asking what he asking, pressure difference between inside and outside. Let us consider this is a bubble. From outside we are getting atmospheric pressure, and from inside surface tension force also inside. So to resist this outside atmospheric pressure and surface tension, internally there will be a force opposite outwardly acting. So the difference between inside force and the outside pressure difference, that is a change in pressure. The question is asking this one. So we know that the formula change in pressure is equal to 8 sigma by D. The sigma is the surface tension. So in terms of radius means 4 sigma by r. For liquid drop, change in pressure is equal to 4 sigma by d is equal to, in terms of radius, 2 sigma by r. So from options, soap bubble means option A is the correct answer. So again, match the following, match list 1 and list 2. Let list 1 is property which explain the spherical shape of a drop of a liquid, property which explain cavitation in fluid flow, property which explain rise of a soap in, what is that, sap, not sap, something, okay, sap in free, okay, property which explain flow of oil jet. So viscosity, surface tension, compressibility, vapor pressure and capillarity. So let's see. So option C is the correct answer. So 2, 4, 5, 1. property which explain the spherical shape of the drop of a liquid is option 2, surface tension. Yes, the bubble is spherical in shape due to the surface tension only. So next, property which explain cavitation in fluid flow. Yeah, cavitation related to vapor pressure, right? Property which explain rise or fall. Yeah, rise or fall in, yeah that one. So which is related to capillarity. Next, property which explain flow of a oil jet, which is related to viscosity, right? So option C is the correct answer. So next question, a wooden block of rectangular section 4 meter long, 1.25 meter wide and 2 meter deep floats horizontally in sea water of specific weight 1025 kg per meter cube. If the specific gravity of wood is 0.64, the depth of block underwater will be. So what is given? Length of the block, width of the block and height, total height of the block. And also given density of the sea water is given and the specific gravity of the wooden block. So what he asking? Depth of block under water. So small h asking. So what he asking? Depth of block under the water. So how to calculate? So we use buoyancy concept. We know that density into volume of water displaced, water or liquid. So volume of liquid displaced is equal to density of block and total volume of the block. So what is given? Density 1025 liquid, right? Volume of displaced fluid we don't know, is equal to density of block 0.64 into 1025 and volume is 4 into 1.25 into 2. So if you calculate, you will get it as volume of liquid displaced is equal to 6.4 meter cube, but we need the height. So volume is length into width into height. So if you calculate like this, you will get it as 1.28. So from option, we can approximately equate it, sorry. So from option, we can equate it to 1.25. So option 4 is the correct answer. Next question, a perfect gas obeys. Option C, both Boyle's law and Charles law. Please remember this. Next, the viscosity of gases increases with temperature. So the viscosity of gases will be increases with increase in temperature. Let's see note point. So in liquid, the dynamic viscosity, the viscosity due to cohesive forces, therefore the dynamic viscosity decreases with temperature because the cohesive forces between the liquid becomes weaker. So the cohesive forces are become weaker when temperature increases in liquids, therefore what happened? Dynamic viscosity decreases, whereas in gases viscosity due to molecular momentum exchange between gas molecules. Therefore, when temperature increases, the molecular momentum exchange in a gaseous molecules increases. That means they will collide each other. Due to that, the viscosity increases in the gas. So what we understand that if temperature increases, viscosity decreases in liquid, but in gases, when temperature increases, viscosity also increases. The next question. The barometer reading is 74 centimeter mercury and 5.05 kg per centimeter square absolute pressure is equivalent to. So given that barometric reading, that is 74 centimeter of mercury. We know that barometric reading will give the measure of local atmospheric pressure, and what he given, absolute pressure also given. So what he asking, the absolute pressure is equivalent to, so from the diagram we can see that this is the absolute pressure till here, and this line is the atmospheric, local atmospheric pressure. So we know that 76 centimeter of mercury is equal to 1 atmospheric pressure. So here given 74, so there is no much difference in these two, so we take it as 74 centimeter. So 74 centimeter is equal to 1 atmosphere, we are assuming, because there is no much difference 76 74. Now we have formula, absolute pressure is equal to atmospheric plus gauge pressure. So if we, from this gauge pressure can be calculated, so we get 4.05. so from the option we can approximate to 4 kg per centimeter square gauge pressure. So option 4 is the correct answer. So thank you friends. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel, like and share, and join the Telegram group. Link is given in the description. Thank you.